members of the administration, board, colleagues, parents, family, and members of the class of 2015. It is my humbled honor to be speaking to you tonight. A mother once said, "I would rather give birth to a baby elephant than raise a teenager again. It would be less painful." I can't believe my darling, sweet little girl has turned 16 years old and has become a stranger, and all she wants from me is money. Well, developmental psychologists agree that the adolescent stage of development begins around the ages of 11 to 13. Adolescence is a time for preparation for adult responsibilities. However, parts of the adolescent brain, primarily which part? That part right there, yeah? It's called the prefrontal cortex. Now, the prefrontal cortex does not fully develop until your mid-20s. But because of this immature prefrontal cortex, teenagers will, and you wrote an essay on this, find fault with authority. Remember that one? You are argumentative and decisive. Does it sound like anyone you know, parents? Hypocritical, impulsive, and self-conscious. As a teenager, I was very good at finding fault with authority and arguing with my parents. In fact, my mother said many times, "You just wait until you have your own teenager." Yep, she was right. I am currently living and raising two teenagers in my home, and I chose a career where I deal with teenagers every day. What was I thinking? Erik Erikson, which again, we've studied him, is a German-born American developmental psychologist, and he's known primarily for his psychological theory on human development. Out of the theories, eight of them, he is most famous for coining the term identity crisis. Starting at the age of 12 and lasting well into a person's 20s, Erikson believed finding one's identity essential to building a healthy personality. Teenagers develop their own identity by exploring their environments and exposing themselves to new situations. Failure to develop one's identity can cause role confusion, where an individual is unclear about themselves and the role they play in the world. Amy Teagarden said, "No matter where you are or where you grow up, you always go through the same awkward moments of being a teenager and growing up and trying to figure out who you are." Every adult would admit going through some transformative and difficult experiences as a teenager. And no matter the experience, we would also as adults agree that there were family members, friends, siblings, co-workers, teachers, who all provided advice and words of encouragement. Adolescents also experience a period called egocentrism. During this stage, and again, think about this in your head, again, if you live with any of these behaviors. During this stage of egocentrism, they believe the world revolves around them. They're always right. And they think they already have everything figured out, and they know exactly how something works. Throughout my own teenage years, I had people who offered advice, but I have failed to apply it, or thought, "I already knew it already." Again, you can thank the prefrontal cortex for that attitude. In retrospect, advice tends to be something you truly don't appreciate until you wish you had taken it. So I've decided to write a letter to my former teenage self, discussing five pieces of advice I wish I had received as an adolescent. Dear Holly, I know that being a teenager is difficult. Society thinks you're selfish and lazy and disrespectful and impulsive. And yet, the pressure to succeed, get an education, a job, can be so overwhelming. You think you know and have everything figured out, but I'm here to tell you, you don't. This doesn't mean that you're dumb. It just simply means that until you gain new experiences, travel new places, meet new people, it is difficult to develop a well-rounded perspective. In order to live a fulfilling life, a person must continue to be curious and learn from others. So I'm going to make some suggestions, Holly, that will hopefully motivate you to learn or grow to the person you are always meant to be. Number one, just like Mr. Joyce, embrace failure. You will experience a lot of rejection and failures, but they may be big or they may be small, but these experiences will help you grow. You want these experiences to inspire you to try harder. Failure and rejection may seem like a setback, but remember what Confucius said 2,500 years ago. Our greatest glory, is not never falling, but in rising every time we fall. Number two, redefine success. The Dalai Lama has advised, judge your success by what you had to give up in order to get it. For some adults and most teenagers, personal, now think about this one when you're, you know, type of major you want to go into or profession. Most teenagers admit that their personal success is measured on the amount of money they will make or the grades that they will earn on an exam. But I challenge you to reshape your definition of success. Embrace a more fulfilling definition, and one that can't be measured by grades or achievements. Number three, be compassionate to others and don't forget yourselves. It's okay to be compassionate towards yourself. You never know what some people have or they are going through. Some of us hide what's truly going on in our lives really well. I know it's a cliche, but take a moment to walk in their shoes. It will give you insight into the lives of others. Don't be the person making jokes about others in class. Don't be that person on the dorm floor making fun of others. Don't be that person in the office who ridicules others. Sometimes being kind or sticking up for others is uncomfortable. Sometimes it means that helping the underdog, or that perhaps you are the underdog. Colossians 3, verse 12 suggests, therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Hold your head up high. Be brave. And know that you could be making a huge difference in someone's life. Number four, invest and save. Begin retirement planning with your first job and save money with every paycheck. You won't regret it. After 40 plus years in the workforce, you're gonna wanna sleep in. You're gonna wanna relax. You're gonna wanna travel or learn a new hobby. Saving money now will allow you to live out your dreams later. Warren Buffett, the famous billionaire investor, advises, do not save what is left after spending, but spend what is left after saving. Also, use credit cards sparingly. You're gonna go to college and they're gonna wanna give you a brand new sweatshirt. And they're gonna have you sign up for this credit card. I'm warning you, use it sparingly. Sure, you might wanna order pizza at midnight sometimes, but remember that $15 pizza could end up costing you twice as much with interest. It's easy to spend now with plastic and much harder to pay later. Finally, 5, be authentic. And I think this is the most difficult for teenagers. Who are you? What do you stand for? Nigerian poet Ben Okri said, "The most authentic thing about us is our capacity to create, overcome, endure, to transform, to love, and to be greater than our suffering." Realize that many of your strongly held beliefs may change in the next few years. As you age, meet others and gain life experiences. So many people are pressured into lives they don't want to live. Be open to new people. Don't pay attention to what people think. You don't have to be who you were in high school. This is your chance to reinvent yourself. No one else in the world will care if you were cool or uncool in high school. Remember, no one can make you feel inferior unless you let them. Let yourself be broken. Feel all those feelings with that experience. And when you allow yourself to be your most vulnerable, that is when your true self will emerge. Holly, I've given you some advice tonight that probably did go through one ear and out the other. But I'm suggesting that you incorporate one piece of my letter into your life. Maybe one that will help you along life's journey. Some people scoff at cliches, but I've mentioned them in this letter. Why? Because the ideas and the expressions were created by people who have faced their own adversity, just like you and me. I challenge you to embrace failure, redefine success, be passionate, save and invest, and be authentic. And most importantly, Holly, remember you are loved. Good luck. Sincerely, your future self. Tonight, Holy Family Catholic High School is sending you, the class of 2015, off to the next stage in your life. Developmental psychologists do agree that teenagers need to become independent, form a self-identity, and realize their role. Barbara Hall probably puts it in another way, a good way. The path to our destination is not always straight. We will go down the wrong road. We will get lost. We need to turn back. Maybe it doesn't matter what road we embark on. Maybe what matters is that we embarked. May each of you embark on your own path to success. And don't forget, you will always be a part of our family. Thank you and good luck.